I know, where is the laundry?
There you go, there's a start.
For as long as Julia Hansen can remember, her husband and 97.3 breakfast radio host Terry has relied on what he calls the laundry fairy.
I may have fallen out of the habit.
You never had a habit.
Whilst Julia admits Terry has hung the washing out before, to disastrous consequences, he's most commonly found in the hammock.
Let me know when you need me.
So I can actually watch the laundry drying and be there at the prime time when it's just dry enough.
To tell me to bring it in.
No, excuse me.
I don't know what it is, but I just like the same coloured peg on the same outfit.
Washing extraordinaire Laurel Hughes has more than just a quirky habit with pegs. After working as a seamstress for 7 years, she's a very particular hanger.
People often hang their tops up wrongly, they'll hang their pants up incorrectly. The towels need to be hung out with 4 pegs to ensure that they keep their shape and they dry quicker.
We see the result of lots of terrible hanging. So we see shoulders askew, necklines that we have to try and steam back into shape.
Like Laurel, Toni-Maree Bishop from elaundry believes there's an art to hanging out the washing. Get the technique right and it comes with a time-saving reward.
If you hang your clothes to dry the right way the first time, you can cut your ironing time in half.
And when it comes to hanging out the washing, believe it or not, there is a right and wrong technique. So we've set Julia and Terry to the challenge.
Always prepare ahead 2 pegs in the hand because you're going to need 2 at least for most pieces.
I like the buttons undone. Terry always puts it in the wash with all the buttons still done up.
Here we've got the trapeze technique and this is a saving on pegs.
Now with a t-shirt I like to just sort of flop the ends over the line like so.
Pull the pockets out, there we go, sort of koala ear style.
With jeans I've always hung them by the band at the top.
2 socks to a peg, fantastic. Undies, just a straight hang I find.
I just hang them by the toes, I guess, so you don't see the peg marks.
Challenge complete. The first item to receive Toni-Maree's analysis is the business shirt. Julia gains a point for pulling her garment tight compared to Terry's trapeze and sag.
But certainly this is not going to work for you.
But both have missed the key to cutting ironing time in half, leaving the buttons done up. Moving on to the t-shirt and Julia gets a thumbs up for turning hers inside out.
It's going to last twice as long, if not 3 times as long, as if you expose that red to bright sunlight every day.
Whilst Terry again loses points for his obvious sag.
At the moment now, if you took this off the line, you were going to wear this tomorrow.
Yeah.
You will have that sag permanently there.
Pants are next, and believe it or not, Terry has the right idea.
Terry, the upside down is terrific. You are on the ball, you really are.
Yeah.
It allows the waistband to dry faster, and by hanging the pants inside out, the pockets will dry without the need for Terry's koala ears.
Then, of course, to socks. No peg marks to be exposed when you're off to school or work, and the toe, which is the most fabric, can dry as well.
But Toni-Maree admits if Laurel was a part of the washing challenge, she'd take out the gold star.
It's important that the material be hung according to the way it's been woven.
And if you'd like to decrease your ironing time even more, Toni-Maree's final tip is to hang all items on a thick hanger.
We can look forward to more personal time and less time at the ironing board.